Hey, welcome back everyone. Toysh is here and I am back yet again for yet another McFarlane Toys Super Powers video. And today we're going to be checking out the majority of Wave 6. Wave 6 also includes a Gold Flash and a Gold Batman. You get those if you buy the entirety of the wave from certain places. I'll put a link down in the description below for Entertainment Earth if you still want to grab that wave. But we got the main four today. And I'm totally stoked on that. They came from GameStop. Majority of things I've been getting lately have come from GameStop. Go figure. The Batman of Zurin R is number one. And I like the colors on this Batman. Now, it's going to be the usual superpowers card. They are 10 bucks a piece. They have interesting artwork, to say the least, right? We'll just go with that. And you can tell they've recolored certain pieces of art to match the figure. The backside of the card, we're getting an abundance of a collection here for the old superpowers resurgence. Now, keep in mind, there are 27 figures listed on the back here, but we are missing the three-pack with Judo Master and Peacemaker and Vigilante. So that would make 30, of which I have 28, because again, I don't have the Gold Flash and the Gold Batman. But I'm sure that I'll live, right? You can also see the most recent vehicles, the Batmobile, the Invisible Jet, and the Whirly Bats. You can read up on old Batman of Zurin R. And of course, here is the barcode. And like I said, if you want these, if you want them from a store, check out GameStop. Next up, we have a Superman variant, of which he hails from Justice League / Justice League Unlimited, the old awesome cartoon. This is the Justice Lords Superman, which, if you got to do a Superman repaint, sure, why not? You can read up on old Justice Lord Superman, and here's the barcode for old Lord Superman. Now, this one is one of the two that I absolutely wanted from this line. Of course, you see the GameStop sticker, right? This being Sinestro, or how the guy at GameStop called him, Sinestro. I didn't have the heart to correct him. You can read up on old Sinestro right here, and of course, the barcode as well, of which they're listing him as a Super Friends Sinestro. But the main one, the one that I absolutely wanted, the one I had to have, straight from the Green Lantern Corps, Hal Jordan. Awesome looking figure, I will say, right? Just lends himself so well to the whole superpowers look, and here's the barcode for Hal Jordan. So, this is going to be an absolute blast. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot cup of coffee. This is a look at the majority of Wave 6 of the brand new McFarlane Toys Super Powers line. Here we go. And just before we get started, I just want to say a quick thank you to everyone who continues to watch my YouTube channel. And if you are new around these parts, welcome. Perhaps you would consider subscribing. Why? Well, we got old toys, we got new toys, we have daily news updates. Guarantee you'll find something here that you like superpowers. And speaking of which, here's everything out of the packaging. Basically, it's a Superman, it's a Batman, and then it's two figures that you actually want to add to your collection. But I digress. There are some interesting things happening, like with the Justice Lord Superman. If you gotta repaint him, make him a villain, and make it a functional villain, right? I like the Justice Lords. If they continue on with the Justice Lords, that'll be even better. Basically, we got a repeat going of the Justice League line from Mattel, right? They eventually completed that, but it took a while. We even got the Justice Lord bots, too. That was kind of cool. I really like the red eyes on this guy. I think they nailed that. You got the Polly Walnuts wingtip hair in the back. Mr. Fantastic sort of situation. The capes still aren't there. They've come a long way since that taffeta nonsense, but the cloth, while it is nice as a drapery, bunches up way too much around the C-clip of the neck. Perhaps they're going for more of a material, right? Kind of flowing out towards the cape. It doesn't look right. Just C-clip it. That's what we like best with the superpowers and the more simplistic, awesome action figures from back in the day. It'll match the articulation. Don't think about it too much. Just make it cool, make it awesome. Same exact articulation as you would expect for a superpowers figure, so nothing special there. And the paint is quite fantastic. Not a bad looking Superman. Batman, however, no, he's pretty good too, I will say. I like the colors on this guy. It's weird, it's wacky, it's wonderful. It's Batman, homeless Batman. stitching together a costume of the most recent, right? I know this guy goes back to what, the golden silver age, whatever. But this Batman is pretty cool. Cape or no cape, we'll just say he kind of has the more elevated C clip, which again doesn't really work. Mine has pretty much perfect paint, except for right here on the shoulder, you get a little bit of a red goop splotch right there. But again, it's simplicity, it's wackadoo-ness. This is a good repaint of Batman if you got to give us tons of Batmans. Now, you get a Sinestro Lantern, Yellow Lantern. That's cool. I like when the superpowers come with some sort of accessories. So it's nice to see. You got the Sinestro Corps logo right there. Totally dig it. Nice lantern. Sinestro himself, one of the best figures of the wave. Beautifully painted, I might add. Nice purples, nice blues. This is a classic looking Sinestro, minus the giant forehead, but I really don't mind that. I kind of like this version better, of course, right? The blues, everything matches. Everything is nice and crisp and clean. You got the yellow ring. They included that. It's sculpted on there. That's a nice touch, huh? On the flip side, the other arm has a hand that allow you to hold the yellow lantern. So I totally dig that. Same exact articulation as you would expect across all the superpowers lines. He's just a nice looking figure. And like I said, when you want him holding the lantern, it kind of comes off as crooked when his arm is outstretched, but down at his thigh, it totally works. So again, one of the best figures thus far of the McFarlane era of superpowers. They nailed the colors, the aesthetic. It's everything Sinestro that you would want and more. But that's nothing compared to old Green Lantern Hal Jordan. And yes, you do get a Green Lantern, of which mine, of course, has a blotch of paint right here on the back. Shouldn't bother me as much as it does, but when you have a cool-looking accessory, you just gotta, it came right off. Never mind. Totally take it back. Hal Jordan, I'm just gonna tell you right now, this is, next to the Blue Batman, the next best superpowers must-have for the McFarlane era. They have achieved the classicness. He has the sculpted on green ring, the white gloves. You can hold the lantern on the other side. Everything about this is a home run. I absolutely love what they've done with this figure. It's simplicity at its finest. And dang it all, that is a superpowers Hal Jordan if I've ever seen one. They nailed it. Awesome job. And like I said, you can hold the lantern on the other side. It's going to be the kind of wonkiness that Sinestro has, unless you want to put it more towards his thigh. But other than that, this is a home run. One of the best of this year. Now, the beauty of superpowers is putting together a collection. So we have a bunch of villains to formulate in here, right? Classic looking villains, which I absolutely love. And then you have some other ones where you're like, yeah, I guess that's good. And for those of you out there, they're going to tell me that Thomas Wayne is not a villain. He's a villain. He teamed up with Bane. He's a son of a gun, and you know it. Justice Lords, Superman, the Batman Who Laughs, you get the idea. Same dealio with the superheroes, although that Aquaman, I hesitated putting him in. They got to redo him. But look at that spread right there of just classic costumes, classic colors, and just tons of fun. Now, yes, various eras, Judo Master, sure, why not? John Stewart is a different color green than Hal, and he has a different lantern. That's a nice touch. Barry, we got to lose that chin strap. Superman, all of them could use little updates here and there, so we're on the right track for the McFarlane superpowers. So that will wrap it up for my quick look at the majority of Wave 6 of the McFarlane era of superpowers. And I'm starting to see they're really getting their footing with what the fan feedback has been. There's not a whole lot of collectors left with superpowers. I know a lot of you out there will disagree. Come on. Let's be honest with ourselves. But in kind of hitting that stride with Wave 6, we got the Blue Beetle ship coming with 7. We got a lot of different characters coming in the forthcoming waves. I'm very excited to see where they're going to take superpowers, and quite a collection we've amassed thus far. But you've heard my thoughts, and now I'm curious to know yours. Comment below, let me know. Let's talk everything superpowers. And I'm going to leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food, but most importantly, remember, can't wait for that Blue Beetle ship and the eventual booster gold. And when we do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.